Hello everyone, welcome on my channel Smart Study. In this video I am going to discuss MCQ of the chapter How the Camel Caught His Hump from the English book It So Happened from class 8. It is the first chapter of the supplementary reader It So Happened in English. This chapter is thoroughly explained with the MCQ so that the student achieves complete and clear understanding of the chapter from all corners. So let's begin with our questions. The first and the foremost question is, name the writer of the story How the Camel Caught His Hump. Options are Oscar Wilde, H.H. Munro, Rudyard Kipling, Robert Frost. The writer of the story How the Camel Caught His Hump is Rudyard Kipling. So the correct answer lies on third option. Oscar Wilde is the writer of The Selfish Giant, third chapter, It So Happened. Similarly, H.H. Munro is the writer of The Open Window, seventh chapter, It So Happened. Choose the correct set of animals in the chapter How the Camel Caught His Hump. In the first option, a camel, horse, dog, and a cow. There was no cow in the story, so first option is wrong. In the second option, a camel, a dog, and a horse were present but not a cat. In the third option, cow and bull are wrong. So the correct set of animals consists of a camel, a horse, a dog, and an ox. Where did the camel live? Options are hut, room, desert, or the howling desert. By looking at the options, we can easily say that the camel did not live in any hut or a room. So we are left with the last two options. Third is desert and the fourth is howling desert. Many students are going to get confused in between the options third and fourth. Let me tell you, desert in the third option with the spelling D-E-S-S-E-R-T means sweet dishes. For example, chocolates and cakes. While desert in the fourth option has single S in its spelling means dry land masses with sand and sand dunes which receives very low rainfall. My upcoming video is based on such confusing words, so subscribe my channel if you haven't subscribed yet. Coming back to the question, where did the camel live? The camel lived in the howling desert, desert with single S. Which of these animals was lazy? Was it the horse, dog, camel, or the ox? All the animals in the desert were assigned their tasks, but there was one animal which was quite lazy and did not perform its work. The correct answer is camel. What did the camel use to eat? First option, fruit. Second option, leaves and branches of the tree. Third option, sticks, thorns and prickles. And the last option is grass. The camel used to eat sticks, thorns and prickles. Next question. What tasks were assigned to the dog and the ox? Let's look at the options. First option is to fetch and carry sticks and to plow the field. Second option, to plow the field and to fetch and carry sticks. This option is similar to the first one. Third option says to bring water from the pool. And the last option, to carry the luggage. Many students must be confused with the first and the second option because both the options are quite similar. If we talk about the dog was assigned the task to fetch and carry sticks while the ox to plow the field. The correct option is first one while the second option is wrong because the order of the tasks assigned to the dog and the ox are given in the reverse order in the second option. So be careful while reading questions and read all the options patiently during the exam. What did the camel say when anybody speak to him? Options, hump, no, yes, or sorry. Since the camel was lazy and did not like to work, that's why when anybody spoke to him, he used to say hump and nothing more. At the end of the day, who called the horse, the dog, and the ox together? Was it the man who called all the three animals, or the jinn, or the camel, or the in charge of all the deserts? The correct answer is the first one. It was the man who called all the three animals, the horse, the dog, and the ox together. The camel, being lazy, was not performing its tasks. That's why the man asked all the three animals to work double the time and make up for the camel's laziness. The man said, 303, I am very sorry for you. Who are these three? In the last question, we have already discussed that the man called the three animals and asked these three animals to work double the time and make up for the camel's laziness. And these three animals are the horse, the dog, and the ox. So the second option is the correct one. Let's move to one of the important questions of this chapter. Why were the three animals, the horse, the dog, and the ox, angry with the camel? Yes, the three animals were angry with the camel, and there was a solid reason behind that. Before I tell you the answer, let's have a look on the available options. First option is, they had to work double the time to make up for the camel's laziness. Second option, the camel used to beat them. No, it's not true. The second option is wrong. Let's see the third option. The camel got larger share of food. This is again wrong. The fourth option is, the camel used to sleep all the time. This option is not the complete answer. So this is also the wrong one. According to the question, the correct answer is, the three animals, horse, dog, and ox, were angry with the camel because they had to work double the time to make up for the camel's laziness. Who was the in charge of all the desserts? Was it the jinn, or the camel, or the man, or all the animals in the desert? The in charge of all the desserts was the jinn. That's why the horse complained against the camel's laziness to him. The correct answer of this question is the jinn, which is the first option. Moving on to the next question. There is a thing in the middle of your dessert with a long neck and long legs, and he hasn't done a stroke of work since Monday morning. He won't trot. Whom is the horse referring to in these lines? Options are the camel, himself, the ox, or the man. In the question, the quoted lines are said by the horse while his conversation with the in charge of all the desserts, the jinn. The horse is complaining, jinn, against the camel's laziness. All the animals are angry with the camel that he does not perform his assigned task. In this question, whom is the horse referring to in these lines? The correct answer is the camel. What was the camel looking in the pond of water? First option, fish. Second, the pool water. Third, his own reflection. Fourth, the other animals bathing in the pool. The camel was looking at his own reflection in the pool water and admiring himself, which indicates that he was proud of his looks and appearance, especially his back. What was the camel proud of? Given options are his back, his legs, his nose, and the last one is none of the above. In the last question itself, I told you that the camel was proud of his looks and appearance, particularly his back. So the correct answer is his back. First option. Next question. What is the puffed up back of the camel called? Dump, hump, humpty, or the last option, none of the above. The puffed up back of the camel is called hump. So the correct answer is option number 2. What, according to the jinn, was the use of the hump? The options are, the hump was a problem for the camel. Second, to carry luggage. Third, to store food and use the derived energy to work for a longer period. Fourth option says all of the above. The hump was neither a problem for the camel nor was meant to carry luggage, according to the jinn. Which means that first and second options are wrong. The camel had missed his work for 3 days. In order to make up for those 3 days, the jinn gave him a hump, which was meant to store food and use the derived energy to work for a longer period of time without eating food. Therefore, third option is the correct answer of this question. With this, we have reached the end of the video. Hope this video will be helpful for you and your friends. See you soon in my next video. But before going, hit the like button and subscribe my channel. And don't forget to share my video with your friends.